What track have you chosen to sing on the album?
I have chosen which you might surprise you, a Taylor Swift song.
I can't believe. Why?
It's not Shake It Off, though.
No, all right, okay, no, which one is it?
It's a song called Never Grow Up from Speak Now, which is, she never released it, and it was my eldest daughter gave it to me, because I sing to the kids and things like this at bedtime, and she gave it to me as one of the songs kind of going, listen, you know, because we share music. She said, listen to this song, this is very you. And I heard this song and wept a little bit, and aww, I then sang it to my kids. I mean, it's when Taylor originally wrote it, it was about herself, so I've removed a verse, which means I can sing it about my kids. I mean, yeah. I don't know if you've got kids yourself or
yes.
It's that thing, isn't it, where you desperately want to create fully rounded human beings, yeah, that are lovely, that can go out into the world, but at the same time you just want to press pause, you just want to slow the world down a little bit and just hang on to these moments that it just goes too quick, yeah. And this song is all about, you know, just don't grow up, just give us a bit longer, remember these moments, take these in, and yeah, it's very difficult to sing without getting upset, to be honest with you.
You mentioned there, big group of you, the all-star group were there on one particular day. But also, the excitement actually continued because you had a special visit one day. From whom?
Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift. She just rocked up, did she? How did it all happen?
She was walking past and she heard me singing and she just thought, I've got to go in there.
Listen, basically, before you say the story, we're going to hear a clip of when it actually happened.
Lovely.
You had no idea whatsoever that Taylor Swift was going to be in the country on that particular day.
My wife had kept it hidden for a month and had been working on this to happen for a month. And about 3 days before it happened, when it was really being locked in, we like to eat together as a family whenever we can, whenever I'm not away filming or whatever. And she was down in the office kind of doing these emails to America. And I went down and I went, babe, come on, what are you doing? We're going to eat together. What's wrong? It can wait. Whatever you're doing, can wait. And she was like, no, darling, it's all right. I'll be in a minute. I was like, oh, come on. And then left, you know, in a mood because we're not eating together. And apparently when I left, she just thought, if you only knew what I was doing. so basically, Olivia had worked with Joe Taylor's... Olivia Coleman, sorry, had worked with Taylor Swift's boyfriend. And so my wife said to her, why didn't you text and just see if she'd come along? And eventually Olivia did, and she texted Joe, the boyfriend, and he sent her a message to Polly saying, here is Taylor's manager's email address. Yeah. So Polly's now in kind of this situation. This is all I found out in hindsight. I found this out because I didn't know anything. She had to compile an email to this manager of arguably the world's biggest superstar.
Totally.
And tell him about me, that I'm covering this song, what Children Need is, what a Colliery Band is, because I don't know if you know, but I've recorded it with Grimthorpe Colliery Band, who are famous for brass stuff.
Yeah.
And they are my ancestors' pit. That's, you know, my dad was down there, my granddad, my great-granddad's, all my uncles, probably where I would have ended up had they not been shut. So I wanted to involve Grimy Colliery Band in my track. So my wife's having to explain to this American manager about what a colliery band is and everything. So she carefully constructs this email, sends it off, and within 5 minutes she gets an email back going, oh my God, this is a great idea, I love it. I'm a Sheffield lad and I love colliery bands.
Oh,
and it just turns out he's a Sheffield lad. And
oh my God, it was written in the stars, wasn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. And then she spent a month arranging everything, you know, and Taylor did everything off her own bat, turned up, her security came, did everything, and she was so generous and giving, and she was so excited about it. She just kept saying, thank you for covering my track. It's one of my favourite tracks. Thank you for covering it. And it's a bit of a blur, to be honest with you. She stayed for about an hour. I took selfies with my kids, who were all in bits. And she was just, as this whole process has been, she was a really generous, beautiful human being who, when I said to her, I kept saying, why are you here? And she just said, I think it's a great thing you're doing, and I want to support it, and I think Children Need a great, and I just want to get behind it for you.
Well, Shaun, what you've done is absolutely brilliant. Thank you so much for speaking to us today.